Often when we talk to businesses, what their expectation is from AI is more insights. Whereas AI can actually help with the actual decision making too. Why do you need the insights in the first place? You need the insights in order to make decisions.
Everybody now has data, and people have gotten into the habit of making predictions. But very few cases, they are optimizing the decision making, the actions, based on those predictions.
Then comes the difficult part. If you actually have a means to be able to predict what the impact of a decision is, how do you come up with the best strategy? And that's where evolutionary computation comes in.
Evolutionary AI, technically, is a machine learning method where we are trying to discover something new.
Evolutionary computation starts evolving decision strategies, not against the real world, that's very costly, but against this model, this mental model that is created based on decisions that have been made historically.
One of the approaches we have developed at Cognizant, called ESP, Evolutionary Surrogate Assisted Prescription. We built a model of the world, the surrogate model. Once we have that model, then we can evaluate candidates and we can do a search.
Because we're using evolutionary computation, we have multiple best decision strategies.
You don't have to take the answer of the model and implement it as is. You can actually adjust some of the parameters and see how it would turn out.
If we're more inclined to saving money versus making revenue, it will try to do the cost-saving strategy while still maximizing revenue as much as possible. And when you set that, the system will tell you what is the best possible on the other two or three outcomes that you're solving for.
They can also develop better expertise. We can run what-if scenarios and this way learn what works.
And that's the direct result of maintaining multiple best decision strategies at any given point in time.
You can define multiple objectives and you get, as a result, not just one solution that's ultimate best, but a set of trade-offs. The human now takes a role of designing what the goals are. One of them might have higher performance, but also higher cost. Another one might be more economical, but not perform quite so well. The experts become more empowered. They can think at the level of goals and objectives and restrictions, costs, constraints. They don't have to think in terms of implementation. The implementation is done by AI.
The trick here is to try to keep up with a changing world and changing priorities. As humans, when we make decisions, our mental model of the world does keep changing. And it's based on our experience. It's not a static one-time affair. And the evolutionary AI system is very similar. We build a model of the world that's the best given the data we have right now. We evolve decision strategies based on that. But then as we implement the decisions in the real world, we collect the outcomes and the decisions and we refine the models.
And if you capture that data, you may have thousands of examples, hundreds of thousands, some cases millions of examples. And then we have the data that it takes to build the surrogate model. We can use this loop to find where we need more data. Then we can go back and we can look at what was learned. The discovery process is very powerful and it can discover things that humans don't know already. And we can develop new knowledge based on that.